chest up, our head up, looking our partner in the eye. We're going to have our sticks. We're going to go across the ice. So two partners over here. We're just going to go across the ice. Now we're going to how fast we're going. We're just going to try to go shoulder to shoulder. Watch this, stand up here. Okay, what we're going to do is have our sticks. Our sticks are going to be on the ice. Just facing this way. Right. What we're going to do is just go across the ice with our partner. We're going to try to keep our chest up. Shoulder to shoulder, hip to hip, our whole body along our side. Our sticks are on the ice, so we make body contact. Right now with our varsity team, we're getting a lot of body contact, a lot of hits. Our guys are hitting on fists, and we're finishing our checks. Our sticks are up high. We're not in control of our sticks. So we take the guy off the puck, takes his assist one, come down and take the puck off the person. So what we're going to do is just look at the partner in the eye. You're going to go across the ice, just slowly, just going to go shoulder to shoulder, get down nice and low. All the power comes on your legs in this drill. Right, if you stand straight up, you're going to get it. Connor's going to knock me down because I have no support down low. So we're going to get down nice and low. We're going to come up and go through our opponent's stick right on the ice cylinder. The angle we want to hit this player at is coming up and through, kind of like the Nike swoosh sign. That's the angle we want to try to take this player at. Come up and through, keep your stick nice and control. You find yourself your stick up here and a lot of control. So we're just going to go shoulder on shoulder, hip on hip. Going shoulder to shoulder across the ice, trying to get as many pops as we can out there, keeping our chest up, working our partner right in the eyes to do that, okay? So let's put it all on these boards right here, and let's go across the ice. Alright?
Gotta keep the head up here. The back is straight. If you lean your face over the ice, you'll fall down. So.
Up on our toes. We're not strong on our skates. We want to keep our chest back, come through with our legs, and come up through that person. Not leaning over like this, getting low with our legs, but keeping our chest up. All right, let's give it one more shot, coming back. So, shoulder to shoulder. That's it for me.
You just go a little farther from each other. You can come together because maybe you're spread apart.
Alright, what we're going to do now is drop the sticks out here and put the sticks down the edge. I want you guys to just hop up. 1, 2, 3, 4, you guys all just hop up. Drop the sticks right to the right behind. What we're going to do is we're doing a pinball over here. The first in the middle is trying to take all the space like one arm, one more base, come on out. What we're going to try to do, everyone, you guys are going to surround me in a circle here. On the pinball, Connor, hop up one more person. All we're going to try to do on the pinball, all you guys are bumpers over. Each time I make a hit with this shoulder, the next hit's going to be a this shoulder. So if I come over, everyone's shoulders will be facing the middle. I can hit any one of the bumpers I want. I can go any random position. So I can come over and make a hit. As soon as I make that hit, this other shoulder's going to come face the middle. And I hit the next hit of this shoulder. So I come in, try to knock the shoulder down, rolling up the shoulder, pass your shoulder. Try to go shoulder on shoulder, couple hits each, then we'll switch. The next guy go in, kind of off there.
You see, as they have to bend their knees, seat down, kind of bend over on their back.
Keeping your chest up and generating pause with your legs. Right here, one more
person. Head up, chest up, power from the legs.
Everyone's shoulder
girl in the middle here. There's two girls and four boys in this group right here.
That's two shoulders, one of them, drop, and drop. And there, what you want to do is stay low and keep your feet moving, especially along the boards. We'll talk about the danger zones over along the boards out there. Whenever you see someone coming, we don't want to get our head low like this. Right? What happens then is the guy's shoulder, his knee, his elbows, everything hits you in the head when you're down low. We want to get low with our skates and our legs and get nice and low, but keep our chest up. Right? The lower we get our head, the more likely we're going to get a chance to get our head crushed into the boards or get a guy's elbow or hip or shoulder, something really strong to hit you over. So we want to keep our chest up, our head up, and keep our feet moving. Let's move over to the board and talk about a little bit of hit and pin over here. If Connor's about to get hit, if he's taking the boards like this, he's only going to fall a little ways. But if he's astride off the boards right over here and I hit him and he falls, he's going to fall violently into the boards out there. That's going to hurt a lot more than this hit right here. So whenever we're getting a hit, we want to stay tight to the boards, a little tighter, Connor. We want to stay nice and low with our legs, keeping our chest up, and keeping our feet moving out there. That'll be tougher for the person to hit you out there. We're moving our feet, staying low, keeping our head and chest up, and nice and tight the boards. See, if I hit them hard enough, I just bounce the boards, and usually it'll bounce off, and the player will go right by us. Right? Something we want to talk about when we're making body contact is D-side. What's the definition of staying D-side of someone? In front of them, where?
Between the neck and the guy.
Say it again.
Between the neck and the guy.
Between your neck and their power. Right, so if I make a big hit, my net's right over here, I hit him hard, boom, and I end up right over here. Am I still on D side?
No.
No, I'm in trouble. If he skates faster than I do, he's going to get a scoring opportunity. If I make a hit, even if I miss the hit and I end up on this side, I still have good position on him because I'm still closer to my net than he is. So what we're going to do in this drill is just take one stride. What we're looking to do when we take body contact along the boards, we want to come at an angle like this so we hit, turn, and we end up in front. He will actually turn into the boards. We end up hitting and pinning. Our hands are low, our shoulders in front, our knees right in between them like this. So that's the angle we want to end up on. We don't want to end up in the battle on his back like this because he pushes off the boards, this push guard. He pushes. I'm not very strong like that. But if I'm in front of him, he starts to push. He actually pushes away. He's not pushing towards the neck. He gets free. He's right over there. So what it's going to look like, we're just going to take one try. Let's just start right here, Tom. Take one stride. Here's the angle we're looking to take away. We're going right in front, taking away the hands, taking the shoulder. I'm in front of his body, in front of his weight. If I end up over here, I'm in trouble because he pushes. Now you lose the side. So let's concentrate on turning that shoulder one more time. We're coming in at an angle. We're taking away his space right in front of his body. We're coming in at an angle like this. And my shoulder ends up in front of his shoulder. My knee and leg are driven into the boards. I lock him in with his other leg, staying nice and low. Okay, so we'll spread out. Let's just go along this end. One try, we'll hit the pitch.
Now, this is a defensive angle check. Your leg is behind. And if you want the puck, this is what you do here when you need to hit and pin. In the neutral zone or in their end, you don't want to get tied up, so you put your inside leg in front. Nope. You ride the player off and end up with a puck.
Right, strong, your upper body isn't as strong as your legs. If we want to lock him in, we want to get our shoulder in front of his shoulder out here. We want to lock in with this elbow. So he tries to combine, we can hold him back with this elbow. We've got a bit of a lock, or like this, he starts going along the boards. Now he has no way to hold him, he just squished right by his finger. Right? What we want to try to do is try to work a little bit on the technique out here. He takes one stride, we want to come off that shoulder. My shoulder and end up in front of his shoulder. Great. Coach Tom made a great point out there. A lot of times, defensive zone, neutral zone, we don't want to get tied up. We're driving that leg in between his leg. We're still taking that same angle, coming in and hitting. But now we're actually our feet are in front of him. Because now we've taken the puck away, we can take it away in the offensive zone. So we're taking that same angle, taking away his time and space in front of his hands. We come in, we hit, we push. Come right through and take the puck, hit him out here. It's one more time, Connor. He makes that stride, that coming off his front foot. And his numbers are right here. Pretty tough to get a hitting from behind where the ref can see his numbers right there. So I want to be off his front shoulder with my shoulder and my elbow. Then I have an anchor so he can't keep going that offensive direction out there. Great, same thing the other direction. keeps going this way, keeps going strong. I want to take the front shoulder. My elbow is locking in my shoulder. See a seat. I'm going to see it this way, away from my neck. So let's really concentrate on getting in front of them. Get your shoulder and your elbow locked in front of them. That's what I'll do for one more minute.
So it's always body on body, stick on the puck. If you have body on body, stick on the puck, you'll automatically have the two right angle checking.
What we're going to do is a neutral zone angling drill, okay? There'll be a line of players this door, a line of players over at this door. We need to talk about angling control, skating a little tiny bit. But Joel, just stand up, Joel. If I'm coming to take the body on Joel out here, and I'm coming straight at it and stick on him, which way can you go?
Pull.
Either way, just as easy out there, right? What about if I just take one step over on him? Which way is he likely to go? Well, he's likely to go towards the boards just because of my body position out there. Another way I can steer him with my stick. If I'm coming up on Joel, my stick's over here like this, which way is he probably going to go? He wants to go this way. I'd probably go the other way because he wants to go away from your stick. So when you're steering people, there's two ways to steer them. One way is with your body position. The other way is with your stick position. Right? So if you watch a guy like Steve Eisen, who used to be a very prolific scorer, and changed into a bit of a defensive player as well, watch him how well he uses his stick. He'll position his stick very intentionally away from where he wants that player to go. So if he wants to steer Joel up these boards over here, he'll get his body in this lane coming at an angle, and he'll get his stick right over here. Because no one wants to stick handle a puck where someone else's stick is. They always want to take it away. So really be conscious as you do this drill. Don't come directly at the player. Let's take a bit of an angle, and let's hit them with our stick as well. So the way this drill is going to work, two players are going to start out of this side. One player is going to take a couple strides, make a pass. The other player will be stationary over there. As soon as they receive that pass, they're going to race down the wall. Right? The first player is going to come in, hit and pin. The second player is going to pick up the puck, go in and have a shot. Right? So we're making that angle. We want to come not straight out of it in a straight line right like this. We want to take a bit of an angle. So if I'm coming at Joel, I take a bit of a path over here, my sticks over here, I force them up. The board's where I want to go. Then I take that same angle, come in, hit, and control the player. Someone else comes in and takes the puck away. Alright, so you know the pucks up at this blue line right here. Blue line right over there, I'll do a quick move down.
So the first thing is you cut the ice in half. Then you steer him towards the boards, then angle and finish.
Heads up, pass the puck to Jordan. As soon as Jordan hits the puck, he's going to go down the boards. So I take a couple strides up.
The strides,
it's
a pass. And there's the angle. Partner picks up the puck. You go, you pass. There he gets it. Let's see him. Pick him up. There he takes him and gets him.
Side on side with the players. So if their player right beside you use the end boards, it's like another player is angling them into you. Alright? So players that are very fast, sometimes you have to take an angle and and give them a little bit of room and just leave them out of room at the end of the rink. Because eventually they're not going to be able to keep going around that way because you're going a shorter distance. So if I'm taking Jordan, he's going down these boards, just go down there, Jordan. He's a very fast skater, he's going along this side. And I can't get that left, but as long as I stay a little over here,
against fast skaters.
I wasn't able to catch up from along the hole, but eventually he ran out of room. I just kept a good angle. I stayed on the defensive side in between him and my net the whole way. Eventually he ran out of room because of the boards. So if you play very quick players, a lot of times you just want to keep that angle so you're still staying in front of them, and the boards will help you angle that player up.
Add the other players, yellow and purple, be on this side. Black, else
if I jump it over to this team, that player's on offense. He has to go back, pick up the puck. The player on this side is going to go tag up the blue one. The other side goes to that player, is going to go pick up the puck. The other player's going to come angle that person, trying to keep him away from their net, which is this end down here. So they're taking that angle, that control skate, using the boards over here. If you pick up the puck, then you become an offense. You're going to try to score down that far end. All right?
85 feet long or 45 feet
long. What I want.
You can also do this, you can shoot against the boards on the other side of the ice. You know, there's one-on-one or two-on-two.
Is Jay teaching goalies or players?
No goalies for Jay. No goalies for Jay. Just that.
Two on two, same idea. Should be creating the angle. Bad angle there, so we're going to cut in on him. Come at the back shoulder. Bad shoulder, they lost him. Go for the punch to get beat.
This is the offensive team. The defensive team has to go back to their own blue. And then take an angle up there, alright? So if I dump it over to this team on the defensive team, that's the last one.
Each team, the defenders back to their blue and then create angles and talk to each other.
So pick up way over here, and every time they can see the focus over here, we have to move some back at the same time. The same will take a little tighter angle, just pass it forward over there.
So we defend from inside to outside.
Take care of
the big ice. Side to outside. Identify your player so they didn't talk to each other. Come through the middle and force him to the outside. He didn't. Went too straight at him. And inside, up into the outside. Up to the middle, I did that one pretty good.
Guys did some two good jobs of doing that out there already. We always want to take away space from the middle of the ice, out to out wide. Right? That's with our body position and our stick position is how we steer people. Alright? So if we come straight at someone, they have a choice to go either way. If we take a step over, now we're steering them. If we put our stick over on this side, now we're steering them over this direction. Alright, let's get all the pucks picked up here. We've got to be on the bus in 13 minutes.